On March 20th, the 1st F-35C Squadron of the United States Marine Corps, Marine Fighter Attack Squadron 314, received its Safe for Flight Operations Certification, SFFOC, at Marine Corps Air Station Miramar. VMFA 314 reached this milestone after working with the U.S. Navy's F-35C Fleet Replacement Squadron, Strike Fighter Squadron 125. They helped the Marines to transition from the F-18A Hornet to the new F-35C Lightning II. This is one of the most important developments not only for the U.S. Marines, but the U.S. military as a whole. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what Safe for Flight Operations Certification of 1st F-35C Squadron, Black Knights of the United States Marine Corps, really means. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Lieutenant Colonel Cedar Hinton, commanding officer of VMFA 314, said, "The Black Knights have met or exceeded every challenge faced during this transition, and I am extremely proud to be part of this fantastic squadron. Today's achievement marks a significant milestone and the beginning of a new chapter in our storied legacy. The F-35C advances our capability well into the next generation of fighter attack aircraft and will keep our squadron and our service relevant for decades to come." Viewers may note that the Black Knights trained alongside VFA 125 at Naval Air Station Lemoore from September 2019 to January 2020. With the certification attained, the squadron can now fly and train without the supervision of the FRS. As noted in the official statement, the SFFOC process ensures the squadron is manned with qualified personnel to implement maintenance and safety programs in support of fleet operations. All transitioning squadrons are required to complete this certification prior to independently conducting flight operations. The squadron will now continue to train in preparation for its first deployment at sea, which will be the second ever deployment of the F-35C. It's important to note that the first deployment of F-35 Lightning II will be done by U.S. Navy in 2021 with the Argonauts of VFA 147 integrated into the Carrier Air Wing II aboard the Nimitz-class USS Carl Vinson. The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II, which is a single-seat, single-engine, all-weather stealth multi-role fighter, is undergoing final development and testing by the United States. The F-35 has three main models: the conventional takeoff and landing, F-35A, CTOL, the short takeoff and vertical landing, F-35B, STOVL, and the catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery, carrier-based, F-35C, Catabar. Apart from the United States, the primary customer and financial backer, the United Kingdom, Italy, the Netherlands, Canada, Australia, Norway, Denmark, and Turkey, although recently removed, are all part of the program. Many other nations like Japan and Israel are also deploying the fighters. On the 2nd of August 2016, the U.S. Air Force declared its first squadron of F-35A fighters combat ready. The fighter aircraft are expected to remain in service till 2050. F-35 is developed from the ground up to be stealthy. Its external structure is designed to deflect signals away from the emitting radar, which makes it hard to detect or track. This is done by having no sharp edges or protruding elements and having a smooth external curvature. Also, it has a coating of radar-absorbing material that reduces the number of signals getting reflected. F-35 has low radar cross-section, or RCS. Against X-band radars, it's stealthy from the front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from the narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, the limited reduction is achieved from the direct front. Classified techniques have also been used to reduce the heat signature of F-35. This thermal profile management of the jet makes it difficult for infrared, IR, homing missiles to target it. The F-35C brings stealth technology to the flat tops for the first time. Only two countries are at this moment close to operationally deploy stealth fighters, Russia and China. Russia President Mr. Putin revealed that a procurement plan is being laid out for acquiring 76 Su-57. The announcement was made during a meeting on May 15, 2019. These jets are expected to be deployed by 2028. The Kremlin previously planned to have 150 of these aircraft in service by 2020. Viewers may note that the Su-57 program had the backing of India, but in April 2018, India pulled out of the project. The main reasons were engine issues and unconvincing stealth characteristics. Su-57 is currently suffering due to engine problems. Sukhoi originally planned to use an advanced derivative of the Saturn AL-31F engine found on its flankers for the Su-57. Su-57 was supposed to have the new AL-41F1 engine. But the AL-41F1 engine ran into technical difficulty and didn't match the required performance criteria. Saturn, the manufacturer, is working on a new and more powerful design known as the Isdalai 30 or Product 30. But even this has been facing developmental challenges and may be available for acceptance testing later this year. Russia is also facing issues with the stealth characteristic of the aircraft, which is an important aspect of any true fifth-generation fighter. As reported in Indian media, Indian experts were of the view that the aircraft's stealth characteristics could not be improved significantly even with future modifications, since it was flawed on many basic levels. China currently has only 28 J-20, of which 8 are initial prototypes. Just like the Su-57, the Chengdu J-20 is having engine problems. China's not perfected its indigenous WS-10, which is used for its flanker clones, Shenyang J-11 and J-15, let alone come close to finishing development of the next generation WS-15 it would need for the J-20. Viewers may know J-11 and J-15 are illegal copies of Russian Su-27 and Su-33, respectively. The WS-10 engine is underpowered and has been a major headache for China. The WS-15 is currently thought to be in ground testing phase, though some reports state that it has entered limited production. Without the WS-15 engine, the J-20 can't cruise at supersonic speeds. In fact, China has not demonstrated it can build any reliable jet engine, even with designs that it basically stole from Russia. Building engines with indigenous design remains even more distant. The Chengdu J-20 is thought to be powered by twin Russian-built Saturn AL-31F engines found on the Sukhoi Su-27 and its Chinese knockoffs. China has even bought Su-35, which many think was to get access to its engine. The Chengdu J-20 also seems to have issues with stealth like its Russian counterpart. Reports have emerged that a Sukhoi Su-30 MKI of the Indian Air Force managed to detect the Chinese Chengdu J-20 jet fighter. Many experts have argued that the J-20 is nothing more than a decorated 4++ generation fighter. It's clear that American rivals have some distance to cover before they field a stealth fighter in battle. The scenario is more distant if we take into account the fact that neither Su-57 nor J-20 can operate from aircraft carriers. This means that U.S. Marines will have a distinct edge when it comes to operating from the sea. Black Knights will be integrated and deployed with U.S. Navy carrier air wings aboard Nimitz and Gerald R. Ford class aircraft carriers. It also has to be taken into consideration, the U.S. has a massive lead when it comes to aircraft carriers, both in terms of quantity and quality, which will enable it to have a massive tactical advantage.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.